Welcome to another lecture on fluid statics. So in this lecture we will discuss about the total pressure as well as center of pressure of an inclined surface which is in contact with a liquid, maybe water or any other liquid. So we have defined total pressure and center of pressure in our previous lectures. So total pressure is nothing but the pressure force acting on an inclined surface or a vertical surface or a horizontal surface or any 2D surface which is in contact with the liquid. The liquid may be water, benzene or any other liquid. And this total pressure is acting through a point which is called the center of pressure. And we have derived the equation for the center of pressure as well as total pressure of a horizontal surface in water, which is the simplest case, and a vertical surface which is in contact with the liquid or water. And we have located the distance of center of pressure from the top surface of the liquid, and we have designated that center of pressure distance from the top surface of water as h bar. And now in this lecture we will discuss about these two quantities, total pressure and the center of pressure, with respect to an inclined surface which is immersed in a liquid or which is in contact with a liquid. We'll follow the same procedure we have adopted for deriving the total pressure as well as center of pressure of a vertical plate. That same procedure is adopted here. You see this figure, this is an inclined plate in water or any other liquid. This is the view when it is looking from the normal direction of the inclined surface. You see this? This theta is the angle of inclination. This is theta, angle of inclination of this inclined plane or inclined surface with respect to the free surface of the liquid. What is shown here dotted is a free surface of the liquid. So this is angle theta made by this surface with respect to the free surface of the liquid. And this OO is a line that is perpendicular to the inclination. OO is perpendicular to the line of inclination or the plane with which that lamina is, angle with which the lamina is inclined with the top surface of the liquid. Okay, and you see some distances marked here in terms of x as well as h. You take a very small strip as we have taken in case of vertical plate. The thickness of the plate is, that strip is dx. Thickness is dx and the width is b. So obviously the area of the strip is b into dx, you know that. And that strip is at a distance small x from this line OO. It is at a distance small x from the line OO. Okay. And g represents the center of gravity of this 2D lamina. G is at a distance of x bar from the line OO. And let P be the center of pressure. Okay, that we are going to estimate. That distance P be the center of pressure, and which is at a distance of x star. You remember this is x star from the line OO. Okay, so corresponding distances, vertical distances from the free surface of the liquid are h. So what is h? H is a vertical distance of the strip from the free surface. Similarly, h bar is that of center of gravity from the free surface. Similarly, h star, you see, that of the center of pressure from the free surface that we are going to estimate. And now you see this triangle. This angle is theta. So if you take this angle theta and h represents this distance and small x represents the distance from the line OO. So this forms a triangle HX theta that is shown here. It represents a triangle. Okay, so this angle is theta and the vertical distance is h and this hypotenuse is x. So it forms a right angle triangle. So what is sine theta? Sine theta will be h by x. Similarly, you will have a bigger triangle and this side will be h bar and this side will be x bar. You see this? This is x bar. And the corresponding it will be h bar and this inclined triangle theta. So you will have a bigger triangle with vertical side h bar and hypotenuse x bar. The angle remains the same. So sine theta will be again h bar by x bar. Similarly, you can write sin theta equal to h star by x star. So this should be very clear. So we are forming this triangle for the analysis of this particular case. Okay, we'll discuss, we'll find out the total pressure on the elemental strip. So this is the elemental strip we have taken. So how to find out the total pressure? I repeat, total pressure is not pressure, but it is a pressure force. So how to estimate that? It is the pressure on the strip into area of the strip. We have seen in case of vertical plate. So what is the pressure on the strip? Rho g into h, because h is a vertical distance from the top surface of the liquid. And area will be obviously b into dx. So this is the total pressure on this elemental strip. Okay, then we will find out sum of all such total pressures on a large number of elemental strips on this plane surface. So how to do that? You will integrate. You see this integration p is integral dp. So integral rho gh bdx, that is written here. So rho g you take outside since constant, into bdx into h. So what is integral bdx into h? Bdx is the area of the strip. So small area, it is represented as dA. So integral dA into h. So this is what, this is the moment of this area dA at the free surface of the liquid. Okay, moment of, first moment of the area dA with respect to the free surface since it is h. So what is integral dA into h? We have seen in case of vertical plate, it will be A into h bar, A into h bar, that is moment of this total surface area with or about the free surface of the liquid, and where h bar is the distance of the center of gravity from the free surface. You remember in the previous case of vertical plate, we have taken this h bar is represented as x bar. Okay, x bar as the vertical distance from the top surface. Here we are using the term h bar. Okay, the vertical distance are marked as h bar, and this inclined distance are marked as x bar, x, x star, etc. You should remember that. And now the moment of inertia, sorry, the moment of the entire surface area about the free surface of the liquid is A into h bar. So how to get P? P will be rho g into, this is rho g, and integral bdx into h is A into h bar. So rho g A h bar, that is a total pressure on the elemental strip. This equation is similar to what we have derived in case of vertical plate. In case of vertical plate, this P was rho g A x bar. So what is x bar there? Again, that is the vertical distance of the center of gravity from the free surface. Here also h bar is a vertical distance of the center of gravity, but remember this is an inclined plate, but so you have to estimate h bar. Okay, and now we'll discuss about how to estimate the center of pressure. So center of pressure we have estimated as, we have denoted as this point P. Okay, and this vertical distance is h star. Okay, and from the line OO, the distance is x star. So that x star and h star forms a triangle. So that sine theta will be h star divided by x star, as already we have explained. So what is the total pressure on the elemental strip? We have seen in the previous slide, it is rho g h into bdx. And now we'll take the moment of this total pressure on this elemental strip about this line OO. So how to get that moment? dP multiplied by the distance of the strip from OO. What is the distance of the strip from OO? That is x. So dP into x will give you rho g h bdx into x. So sum of all such moments, that will be integral dm. You see this? So it will be integral rho g h bdx into x. You take rho g outside, you get integral bdx into h into x. So here you substitute for h in terms of x. So what is h? H is x sin theta. So you substitute here, you will get bdx into, instead of h, you can substitute x sin theta into x. So x square sin theta. So that is written here, rho g into integral dA. Bdx is dA. So integral dA x square sin theta. Or rho g sin theta you take outside, integral dA x square. What is integral dA x square? we have seen in case of vertical plate, it is the second moment of this area dA with respect to the line OO, dA x into x. dA into x is the first moment of this area, dA into x or dA into x square is the second moment of this area, but second moment of this area is termed as moment of inertia. So this is the moment of inertia of this area with OO. So how can we write M is rho g, okay, you take sin theta out, so you'll get sin theta here. Integral dA into x square will be IO. IO is a moment of inertia of this area with OO. Okay, so that is a M, total moment. So as we have done in previous cases, this is M will be the total pressure P multiplied by x star. Why? Because moment of this total pressure with line OO, P into x bar, where P is the total pressure. What is x star? Remember, this is x star, distance of this P from line OO, this inclined distance, okay, P into x bar. What is P? P we have found out in the previous slide, rho g a h bar. So substituting for P equal to rho g a h bar, you get M will be rho g a h bar into x bar. This equation 1, this equation 2, moment. So you can compare these two equations, equations 1 and equation 2. You get x star as, what do you get? I o sin theta divided by a h bar. That is x star. X star is this distance, x star or x dot. But from this triangle, what is x star? Okay, x star is, you take x star is h star divided by sin theta. That is written here. X bar is, sorry, x star is h star divided by sin theta. Okay, so substitute in 2, what you will get? H star equal to IO sin square theta divided by A H bar. What we have done? We have substituted X bar in terms of H star. Okay. So H star you are getting as IO sin square theta by A H bar. Okay. So what is IO? It is a moment of inertia about OO. Okay. So we have the famous theorem in engineering mechanics, IO equal to IG plus a x bar square. What is ig? We have seen already, it is the moment of inertia of the surface about its center of gravity, and a x bar square, x bar is the distance of the center of gravity from the line OO, so x bar square. So if you substitute for io, ig plus a x bar square, you can substitute here. So what you will get? You get h star as ig sin square theta by a h bar plus a x bar square sin square theta by a h bar. Okay, so you can simplify this. H star equal to what you get? Ig sin square theta by a h bar plus what you will get? A you can cancel off, x bar sin square theta. What is x bar sin theta? From this triangle, x bar sin theta will be h bar. You see this? X bar into sin theta will be h bar. So x bar square sin square theta will be h bar square. So you will get h bar square divided by h bar will give you h bar only. So h star is h bar plus ig sin square theta by a h bar. What does it mean? This is h star, that is equal to, you see this distance, h star equal to h bar, that is this distance h bar plus a distance that is equal to ig sin square theta by a h bar. So obviously h star is greater than h bar, h star is greater than h bar by a distance ig sin square theta by a h bar. So what are the values you require for the estimation of center of pressure in case of a vertical plate in contact with a liquid, that is h star? You need to get the value of h bar, that you can easily find out, you know, that is a position of the center of gravity from the vertical, from the free surface of the liquid. And theta, obviously, that is the angle of inclination of the plane with respect to the horizontal direction or with respect to the water surface or liquid surface. And A is the area of the plate. If you know the dimensions, you can find out the area of the plate. And what is Ig? Ig is the moment of inertia of the plate about its axis passing through the center of gravity. So different plates, if you take a vertical plate, you have an equation. Sorry, if you take a rectangular plate, you have an equation for Ig, circular plate, triangular plate, etc. You can find out Ig very easily. So this is how we estimate center of pressure as well as total pressure for an inclined surface in contact with a liquid. And you remember this, this Ig equation, I'm sorry, this H star equation, you can take it common. You can take it common for all plates, whether it is vertical, horizontal or inclined. You can substitute suitable values for theta. Okay, you substitute suitable values for theta, you will get corresponding equation for the center of pressure. Thank you. And before we wind up, we'll have a small task. This is for finding out the moment of inertia of the planar surface, because you need essentially the value of the moment of inertia Ig about the center of gravity of the plane surfaces in order to satisfactorily do the numericals in this section. So you need to find out the value of the moment of inertia Ig. So you should know that, how to estimate this. So the task is like this: what do you learned by the term moment of inertia? Okay, how to calculate MI, that is moment of inertia of any 2D shape, maybe a rectangular, square, circular, or any other shape, tetrahedron, you know, if the dimensions are given. So prepare a table for the calculation of MI of any 5 shapes. So you can refer to your engineering mechanics notes and all, books and all. So you can draw 5 shapes, and you can write in the next column, you can write the equations for the estimation of moment of inertia of the corresponding shapes. So that will help you for doing problems in this section. Thank you. We'll discuss more about submerged bodies in water, that is three-dimensional bodies in water or liquid, whether it is floating or submerging, we'll discuss in the coming slides. Thank you.